Hey guys, it's Rory Kerberz, and welcome to my brand new Prefix 16 in secondary career mode. This one with Fire Nord. Yes, for the first time in my YouTube, I'm bringing a Dutch career mode into the fray. Yeah, I've done Dutch career modes before, but never on YouTube. So, this should be a lot of fun. The only downside is that I won't have European football as I stated. I found out that Feyenoord aren't in the Champions League or the Europa League. I know I could have put them in, but I wanted to keep it realistic. If they didn't have it in real life, I won't have them in it in the game. That's just the way the cookie crumbles. Sometimes. And I am liking the look of the team. There's some decent players here. Yeah, he should be fun to play. Right? And former Liverpool man and himself, Dirk Kuyt. Jesus. 35 years old. I'm pretty sure he said it was his last year as well, so that's should be fun. He's already captain. I did not make him captain. He was captain when I got here. Van Burke, who I used in an off YouTube career mode. He's a good young defender with high potential, so looking forward to playing with him. And Kongolo, who I used in last year FIFA. Haven't got the chance to use him in this year's one, but it was and when I saw him, I was like, oh yeah, that's where he plays for Feyenoord. I completely forgotten who he had played for. Or I don't know why, but I thought it was some German team. Maybe I was thinking of someone else. Maybe that was Sewell I was thinking of. I don't know why I thought Kongolo was with a German team. But anyway, let's get into the first match of season 8. First away game of the season against ADO Den Haag. I am 100% positive that I probably pronounced that wrong, because of course I did.
Hi there everyone, Martin Tyler here. Alan Smith's alongside me, and we've got action today from the Dutch First Division, the Eredivisie.
Yeah, hi Martin, delighted to be here.
Well, I have nothing against starting career modes with an away match. I always feel like, if I ever get a job in real life, I will pray that my first game is a home game.
Here's his chance, it's his start today.
Yeah, a goal here would certainly help his cause.
Because you're almost under extra pressure. Or at home. And especially when it's your first game. In this case, it will be at least my second game. I haven't looked, I don't know if the second game is away or home. I didn't look at the fixture. So I don't even know who the second game is. I'm sure it'll pop up at some point during this match. They normally talk about the next match at some point during the game.
Taking on his man and beating it into the attacking third. This is a good opportunity.
Well, Henna. Probably pronounced his name wrong. It's safe to assume I'm going to pronounce a lot of names wrong. Except the ones that I know, like Dirk Kuyt. Although, there's two ways of pronouncing his name, isn't there? Because a lot of people call him Kite.
Crossed it well. Defender blocked the cross.
But I'm going to stick with Kaut, because that's what I always called him.
In the news,
well, I always called him that. The German guy who scored a lot of goals, because he did get a good few goals as a Liverpool. Very fair to him.
A big decision.
I'm sure there's not a Liverpool fan on the planet.
He has cleared the danger.
Who doesn't remember where all the goals that Dirk Kuyt got in his time?
Opportunity to
get a Liverpool shirt.
The free kick is in a really threatening position.
And are thankful they did, because there were a lot of really important goals. And not even halfway through my first match, and someone's already been sent off. Luckily, it's pretty hard team. I mean, he was asking for trouble. He is super lucky it's not a penalty, but it is definitely a free kick.
Free kick on target.
And that's always going to happen on terrible free kicks. Everyone knows this. Yo, they're already making a substitution. Might not matter. No, it doesn't. It's 1-0. Well, despite missing the free kick, well, I did get on target, but I didn't score. I just hit straight at the keeper. They're not a particularly good free kick. And, you know, it's not the best looking goal. It's swinging it to the... Kramer, is it? Kramer? I think I got...
And he's moved in trying to jostle the opponent up his
side. I'm trying to remember for what show there was a guy called Kramer on. Was it Seinfeld? I'm sure there's someone shouting at their computer screen that it probably doesn't matter. You're probably right, it doesn't. Well, it's 1-0. Well, and Kramer scores the first goal of my reign as final boss. One out of you. Ah, I was going to pass the ball and perhaps get a second goal.
Well, it's probably one of the simplest he will score in his career. Couldn't really miss that, and he converted
unless it. His first name is Michael, but it doesn't. It's not spelled, you know, the normal way. Again, this is Holland we're talking about here. So, I'm sure they have different ways of spelling all sorts of names.
Fine cross.
Go, Hannah. Couldn't find his way to count, but oh yeah, we'll stick it home for 2-0. Doing the Cristiano Ronaldo celebration.
He just feels sorry for the keeper, really. The way he's hit that to his right, he's got no chance of getting a hand on it.
And talk about arrogance. Oh yeah, if you're going to be in this team's Cristiano Ronaldo, you're going to score a lot more goals. I'll have to look at your free kick. Thanks. But he is off the mark, so maybe he will be his career mode's Cristiano Ronaldo. Maybe he'll blast in all the goals. There's always one player who is ahead of the rest in terms of goals. Who will it be this time?
El Ahmadi. That's a nice bit of skill, but the defense.
Bojanovic.
Coming in now. Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
Again, probably said that wrong. N'Golo.
And it's a header. Terrific.
Oof. Almost made it 3-0. I think it was Kramer again. Yep, 31. Sure was. Oh, well, it was an assist.
That's out of danger there with that clearance.
Hamidi. Kramer. Back to Vahana. Oh, I didn't get the proper contact. We got a better contact on that. That's 3-0. The game would probably be over. Oh, yes! Hey, it's 3-0 anyway. Hey, look at this guy's face is almost completely covered in air. What the hell?
Into the box from that left hand side.
Sorry, I haven't learned the numbers yet. And so I'm gonna need to. Who scored it? Is it Valhanna? I think it might be Valhanna. Sure, the defender. Is it an own goal? No, it is Tony Valhanna. Tony with two N's, apparently. Okay, fair enough.
Situation here, 3-0 as the game gets underway. This is going to be a throw.
3-0 against 10 men. Surely that is game over. Count! Oh! He didn't catch it as I had hoped. Well, that could have been 4-0 right there.
Angel Di Maria has moved to Paris Saint-Germain.
Well, we're here in around £45 million, and for that kind of money, the fans will be expecting something pretty decent.
Oh, crap. Well, miscommunication there between teammates. It's ended my possible attack on that game. Huh? Go on. Oh, yeah? He's going to get there? Kramer. For 4-0. Why did... Apparently I have to blast it with Kramer because he is like, he tipped it. Okay, what the hell?
Got the ball back.
Great tackle, but yeah, Hamidi. He couts. Go on, Dirk. Go on. Dirk couts. What is it with no one hitting it with any kind of force? What the hell?
Elia.
The Vijinovic. Again, name can't pronounce it. Trying my best here.
I'm
having it.
Elia.
This his name is pretty.
Great tackle.
Come on, Elia, you can win it back.
It's gone out.
I'll take the throw. I don't need a score anymore, though, but I want to. Elia! What was that? What the hell was that?
The net wasn't required behind him. Still 7 minutes. Well, it's clearly offside, and...
Yeah, figured I'd be offside. Just get lumped it down the field. I'll not expect the flag to go up. I don't live in a world where offsides are not a factor. I did. Oh, I have so many
goals.
Dang it. I can see a few more goals.
The winning team are doing the same as well. Blow the whistle, ref. And they've got to score soon.
Well, it's not going to be a complicated approach now. Long balls into the box. Many
and again, I'm offside.
A little too eager to get in behind the opposition.
Well, there's no avoiding the fact that I'm going to win this match. I think that's been pretty clear since the red card. It was just a case of how many I would score. And unless I score from this corner, the question's answer will be 3. And it is 3 because Kramer missed. Of course it did. 3-0. Hell of a day. First, him. He dominating performed. Hence, the opposition player who was red carded was Kyle Ebikilo. So yeah, he's not gonna be a popular guy in the locker room, because normally they're pretty much guaranteed that they were gonna lose to me. But he's gonna be suspended now, which means he's gonna miss their next game. And since it was a straight red card, he might get a 2-game ban. Red Star, PS3 also won their first game. Ajax yet to play. Just looking at the other teams that are well known for being up there amongst the best, and PS3 and Ajax are definitely the two other names that would come to mind when talking about the best teams in the Dutch League, or the Eredivisie as it's called. And hey, we're starting off the episode with a new signing. Mark Setendera. I have no idea who he is. But the board wanted said I should look at a central midfielder, and that's exactly what I've done. Apparently I've signed a top player as well. Interesting. Sorry. You bitch. Sorry about that. But yeah, as I was saying, sorry, Evage, but you were in my place. They said they wanted a central midfielder. You were the lowest rated, so I assumed they meant you. Tough, right? Could have happened to anyone. This guy can actually play anywhere in the midfield, and he's 19, so I'm going to assume he has a good bit of potential on his side. Have to work on his penalties, which are trash. Although 78 free kicks, you know, with a bit of work, I think he could be one of the top free kick takers in all of football. About a little work. AZ are my next opponent. I'm already playing the team in second place. What kind of bullshit is that? Okay, I'm playing the team in fourth place because PSV have passed me. But they've already dropped 2 points, which is fantastic. Where am I at? They drew both their games. Okay, fair enough. Great. So the two teams you'd instantly think, okay, they're going to be your main rivals. Yeah. I thought they did. I ignored a transfer offer. Yeah, I'm not selling Alamedi. I have no reason to sell him. Break up some weight budget in case I need it later. But anyway, let's get into a second away game. So I'm not gonna have a home game in this episode. You have to wait and see if it comes in the next episode. This is disappointing. I wanted to play my first home game. Big! At least he's going that way.
Hi there, everyone. Martin Tyler here with
Stadion Nader. Nader.
First division, the Eredivisie.
Yeah, hi Martin, delighted to be here.
Ain't that great at pronouncing things, ladies and gentlemen? What are that? Top class 10 out of 10. Sure. Ngolo. Nice early run after defense. Penalty! Imagine. That would have been a soft penalty. Thing is, I've seen. No penalties given for when there's blatant penalties not given.
It could almost be a 4-5-1 if they decide to come over all defensive, this team. But if they're on the
fact, it happened a lot in the towards the end of the last career mode, and in my Liverpool career mode as well. Did I just see their goalkeeper's name is Coutinho? I wonder if he's anything to Philip. Oof! Oh, he just got saved by the woodwork.
From this position, they can maybe work something more significant.
What are the odds? They find another freaking Coutinho. Obviously, you know, an outfielder like the Liverpool one.
Shut off now. Very good stop here.
Oh, but a great save from the keeper. Gee. That could literally stand for anything. Especially if he's a Brazilian like you, like Philip.
And he's read the situation perfectly with that interception.
Counts. Stradella! On his debut! Puts the ball past Coutinho, and it's 1-0. That sounds so weird. It's a little fun. It sounds weird. I've come up against a goalkeeper called Coutinho. It's going to be interesting. I won't bring it up again unless it's necessary, but what a debut by Stendera. First game, scores inside 20 minutes. Good for him. Good for him. Didn't really give the opposition goalkeeper any chance, did it? He was a good and strong, powerful strike. Which is something that I lacked in the first match, so brilliant.
Johansson.
And muscled off the ball, so apparently his strikes are maybe the only thing about him that's strong.
Fine cross.
That's gonna be an easy cross for my goalkeeper who doesn't grab it. He punched it up in the air. What an idiot. Are you looking to lose your job because of a new goalkeeper? I remember very interesting. I mean, that's not the kind of goalkeeping I expect from a 78 rate.
He's given it straight to the opposition. The manager will go into this with extra zest, really. Played 1-1.
Oh, Hannah.
Oh, results are everything for the manager.
Hannah, off the post! Are you kidding me? How lucky can you get? That should have been a second goal. That should have actually been the second goal of the season for Kramer. But instead, it was a fantastic save by the AZ goalkeeper. I've had my laugh about the fact that he has a similar name to a Liverpool player. I won't keep laughing about it. Ref, that could have easily been another red card. Just saying.
absolutely no trouble.
Great catch by the he's a keeper, but I didn't exactly make it difficult, did I? Just kind of hit it into the box.
Here's the cross.
Oh, yeah. Count! Oof! Still looking for his first of the season. We know he's dangerous in the air. We've seen him score a few headers for Liverpool.
It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball. Well, he could go for goal from here.
Oh, referee's given a free kick against Johnson. Probably pronounced his name wrong. Again, doing it to everyone else. Oh! Alamedy, how did you miss? Oh! Wow, really? How did he miss?
He got himself a goal to put his team in.
Oh, that should have been 2-0.
Moving again for the start of the second half.
I really need to get the second goal. I'm not comfortable with 1. No. No, I'm normally very good. Yeah, waiting with any kind of cushion. 1 goal lead. Hell, even 2 goal leads aren't secure. And no lead is really secure until the final whistle goes.
And the ball knocked away long.
Stojanovic.
Kout.
Van Dirk. Go on, Kramer. How did you... Fuck. Oh, well, it's 2-0. Well, that's all I know. I'm not sure how Kramer did not put his header away. Like, he headed it backwards. How the hell did he do that? Like, he is lucky Valhalla put that in the back of the net. And is Valhalla going to be my top goal scorer? Because he's already got 2 goals in 2 games. Maybe he will be.
That's a straightforward piece of
Kramer couldn't get there in time. After they're fighting to get the ball. Hold back. Lemon. Count. Go on, Dirk. Go on, Dirk.
Shots on!
Fights in the box! Oh! If only the keeper had been stupid enough to cross the line. Valhalla.
Arsenal have spent some of their incoming money. It's outgoing on this player.
Stojanovic.
That's a gift for them.
Oh, it's a known goal! What happened there? Stojanovic whips it in, and the defender, for no reason, Kramer's over here. Kramer's miles away from him. He is under no pressure whatsoever. It is a fantastic goal. Unfortunately, it's an own goal from Jupp van der Linder. Wow. Hang your head in shame, dude. Like, you'd understand if Kramer was right there and he was... obviously, he's trying to get it out of play, but he's not even under pressure. I mean, he could have taken it down. I mean, I can't have the excuse that he didn't know where Kramer was, because is he going to be... he take in a few seconds to just quickly pick a glance, see where Kramer was. That was completely unnecessary. It's another defender who's made a complete idiotic mistake against me, and has pretty much buried his team. In the first game, it was the guy who got sent off. In this game, it's the guy with the comical own goal. What in the name of goodness was he thinking?
And it's a shot that the goalkeeper can deal with quite comfortably. And he's moved in.
Kramer must be wondering why he's getting absolutely no sort of luck. Really, since his goal in the... Since he scored the goal in the first game, he's not... He had any sort of luck. Everything else seems to be going... And in general, the key of the team, or... The luck is falling to one particular her teammate.
Trying to open up the defence with that through ball, the defence wouldn't be opened up.
I'll have to keep my eye on that.
Well, they've lost the ball.
I mean, I don't want a situation where I'm looking at a Hansen.
Shots on here.
I'll make the I'll say it in that post. Obviously, you know, luck not falling his way, he can't truly be pinned on him. But if his performances don't generally pick up, maybe a new striker will be warranted. How did Cal keep that in? That was fantastic. And clearance.
They kept on going to make this a very big...
And it's a second consecutive 3-0 win. Gino Coutinho. Okay, that has to be some sort of joke, right? Right? It's not just me, right? Anyway, on that bizarre note, I think I will take this time to end the video. A great start to the season. Two consecutive away he wins. Hopefully, I'll have a home game in the next episode. Because that would be nice, you know. Still haven't had my first home game as Fire Nord manager yet. You know, away form is cool and all, but, you know, I want that home game. Is Vitesse that home game? Please, come on. Don't have three away games in a row. Hey! It is a home game. Thank goodness. So yeah. In the next episode, I will have games against the Test and... Ooh, PSV. So two interesting games. One of them should be huge. Already, the second episode is already. Can't miss! PSV! They're gonna be up there at the end of the season, guaranteed. I mean, they won the league even in real life. So, do not miss the next episode. Well, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button. And if you're excited for the new secondary career mode, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.